someone who is the most famous woman in Pakistan is pretty much unknown in some places, including Britain and America. Aafia was a very well-educated young woman from a family of educated people, and she got a PhD from Brandeis in education. And unfortunately, she was married to a chap who was very abusive, and she had a very difficult marriage. After 9/11, of course, things were very different in America for people who are Muslim, and there was all sorts of problems. Her husband, bizarrely, had ordered night vision goggles and bulletproof vest online, so the FBI came around, and then someone in Saudi Arabia sent $70,000 to their bank account, and so the FBI came around again. And this was the husband's doing, but astoundingly, no one was arrested. Aafia was freaked out. She had two small children at the time. She goes back to Pakistan. Her husband comes back soon after. They have a very acrimonious divorce, even though she is pregnant with their third child. So as they're going through the divorce, we get into early 2003. And for reasons I can explain, it's a long story, the US government, the CIA, gets it into their tiny mind that she is some big time Al-Qaeda person. She had nothing to do with Al-Qaeda. And I can't tell you over the last 25 years how many cases I've done where I get to see the intelligence, and I can't talk about the intelligence, but, oh boy, the mad things that people thought they knew. I mean, you may be familiar with Binyam Mohammed, one of my clients from Guantanamo Bay, British guy, who was thought to have created the nuclear bomb plot, and it turned out to all come from a spoof magazine from the 1970s. Similar things happened to Aafia on March the 30th, 2003. A group of cars surround her, and what happened so many times in Pakistan happened to her, which was the US government had paid a bounty of $55,000, a huge amount of money in Karachi, because they wanted to detain her. But pretty unique that they detained her as a woman. She's the only woman who went through the rendition to torture program properly. But what was totally unique, they abduct her three children, Suleiman, 6 months old, Mariam, 3 years old, and Ahmed, 6 years old. As they wrench her out of the car, she has Suleiman in her arms, and she ends up dropping him as they pull him out of her hands, and allegedly, he falls to the ground on his head and is killed. Now, that's never been confirmed by the CIA. A second child, Mariam, who is a US citizen, she is taken from Karachi 1,000 kilometers up to Kabul, where she's forcibly adopted into a white Christian American family. Now, what happened to Ahmed, age 6, US citizen, is unique. He was taken by the CIA from Karachi, again 1,000 kilometers north to Kabul, where he was put in prison. Meanwhile, Aafia is taken to Bagram Air Force Base, where she's tortured, where she's in a chair, strapped to the chair, looking through a window, where they're abusing children on the other side who are meant to be her children. Now, all of this the US CIA denies, and my job for the last several months has been to go to Afghanistan and prove the truth. It's always hard, you know, the CIA is not a friendly, open organization, but we've now proven it.